In order to perfect your automation game, you'll need to test and modify the performance of your workflows. One of the most effective ways to inspect this type of data is by designing an A/B split test, which examines the performance of your automation by creating two versions of the same workflow to see which one performs better with a sample of your audience. Overall, implementing A/B testing in your workflows can help you make data-driven decisions, improve engagement, and drive better results from your email marketing campaigns. Users under the Growing or Advanced plan can now use the A/B split testing feature in their automation workflows. To get started, head to the Automations page, create a new automation from scratch, and give it a name. At first, it's going to flow just like any other automation. Set the trigger, hit the plus icon, and select A/B split testing. Give this test a name and use the slider to select what percentage of subscribers will receive each version. The test analytics will appear right here, and as soon as subscribers go through these steps, the stats will populate this section. Keep in mind that there's no limit to the number of A/B tests you can add to a single workflow, so it's highly recommended to name each split test step to help you stay organized. You can also add a third variable by clicking plus add path C if you have a wide audience and want a deeper analysis of your content engagement. Let's do it. Now, I'm going to go through this really quickly and build a test, but if you need a refresher on how to build campaigns with MailerLite, follow the links in the description of this tutorial. Now, the main difference you'll see here is that there are no conditions or actions. Why? Well, simply because the objective of this test is to see if your subscribers engage with the content. So to keep the A/B test simple and effective, we are only working with the email and delay steps. So I'm creating a quick flow here, adding three delay steps and three emails to each side of the test. I'm testing different subject lines, sender names, different content, images, videos, titles, etc., and different delay times. Once you're happy with the test, click the bottom plus icon to continue building your workflow. In this example, I'm going to send out two promotional emails and a follow-up email. And now we put this to the test. Which will perform better? I'm going to save the A/B split test and turn the automation on right here. It's important to note that automation A/B split tests do not automatically select a winner after a certain period of time. You need to manually end the test and select the winner. You can either choose a winner directly within the workflow editor, select the A/B split test, view the results and identify the branch that performed best, then click choose the winner, or you can view the results on the automation overview page. In the dashboard, click on automations, select overview, and here you can monitor the progress of your A/B split test or tests and click choose winner. Now, I'm going to select branch 3 because it's clearly performing the best. If you haven't selected a winning branch yet, you can delete any step in the A/B test. But if you already chose the winner, you can only delete steps from the winning branch. To delete a step, switch off the automation first, then hover over the step and click the trash icon. You can also remove the entire split test or the branches by clicking the trash icon here.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to click the bell button below so you don't miss any new tutorials. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our newsletter. The link is in the description section below. Have an awesome day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.